Safe to say Rudy Giuliani has been all over the Ukraine controversy. He's said to have been involved in a shadow campaign to promote President Trump's theories and interests at nearly every step along the way. Now there's new information that the president's personal lawyer may be caught up elsewhere in a different Eastern European nation, Romania. Here's CNN senior investigative correspondent Drew Griffin.
It took just one errant statement from Donald Trump to put critical focus on the real business of Rudy Giuliani, selling his connections to Donald Trump.
Well, I think what Biden did and his son, and now I guess they're finding also Romania, that just came out today, or some other country, and I'm sure there are more than that.
What happened in Romania is now in the spotlight, but not for what Joe Biden's son Hunter did. President Trump's attempt to deflect from his troubles has connected the dots between Hunter Biden and Trump's own personal attorney, Rudy Giuliani. And law professor and ethics expert Kathleen Clark says Rudy Giuliani could be in real trouble.
What Giuliani did is so much worse than what Hunter Biden did.
It all centers around this man, Gabriel Papaviciu. He's a Romanian businessman convicted in a land fraud scheme north of Bucharest. His case, part of a lengthy struggle by the former Eastern Bloc country to crack down on corruption, including corrupt politicians. Something the U.S., through official channels, has been pushing for years, according to former Deputy Assistant Secretary of State Heather Connolly.
For Romania, its fight against corruption is its fight in some ways for its survival as a democratic state.
To help him fight corruption charges in Romania, Papaviciu turned to power brokers in the United States. He first retained Hunter Biden when Biden's father was the vice president. It didn't help. Papaviciu was convicted in March 2016. Biden referred the case to another well-connected attorney, former FBI Director Louis Free, to help with his appeal, a source told CNN. The appeal failed. Free hired Rudy Giuliani. And Giuliani wrote this letter to the president of Romania just months after becoming the private attorney for Donald Trump in 2018. Giuliani has said in interviews Free's firm paid him to write it, though it did not mention Papaviciu by name.
It sounds just like the propaganda that we've been fed by the former government. Weakening the rule of law, decriminalizing abuse of power, amnesty for corrupt people.
What the letter did do was attack Romania's anti-corruption unit. It said there was damage to the rule of law, and that directly and negatively affects the flow of foreign investment in Romania. Giuliani demanded amnesty to those who have been prosecuted and convicted by the unit. Less than 2 months earlier, the U.S. State Department and 11 other nations issued a statement that was the complete opposite of Giuliani's letter, urging Romania to continue this crackdown on corruption. Opposition party official Sebastian Burdija said Giuliani's letter was a shock.
There was Mr. Giuliani basically siding with the crooks, siding with the government who was trying to roll back anti-corruption reforms. When somebody as important as Mr. Giuliani, as close to the president, speaks on this topic, the country listens, the Romanian people listen. And so, again, confusion, frustration, and just simply, you know, puzzlement as to why somebody would do that.
The letter, especially in light of what Giuliani has been doing in Ukraine, is extremely troubling to ethics expert Kathleen Clark for what Giuliani left out.
He was paid money. Louis Free asked him to write that letter, hired him to write that letter, and he doesn't reveal that. And so the people who receive it, the Romanian politicians and then the Romanian public, they don't know how to receive this letter. They literally do not know in what capacity Giuliani is writing.
It is clear from the letter he is more or less threatening future investment in Romania. Certainly at that time he wrote it, he was very much visibly President Trump's lawyer.
That's correct. It's sort of rhetorical saber rattling on Giuliani's part. I think it interferes with U.S. anti-corruption policy internationally.
Rudy Giuliani's response to CNN about his Romanian letter begins with asking CNN, "Are you serious?" He goes on to say, "I was giving an opinion in an area where I have 50 years of experience, criminal justice." Then he launches into an attack about the Bidens. Ken McCallion, a former federal prosecutor, says Rudy Giuliani may be showing signs of stress.
So there's this jumble of legal representation, business dealings, and private diplomacy that Mr. Giuliani is engaged in that I think, from what I hear, is a subject of some intense scrutiny by the U.S. Attorney's Office for the Southern District of New York, which he formerly headed up.
According to his firm's own website, Giuliani Security has done business all over the globe, including in Ukraine, Guatemala, Colombia, and El Salvador, and Serbia, reportedly making millions. Democratic senators have asked the Department of Justice to investigate Giuliani's foreign entanglements since he started working for President Trump, including a meeting with the King of Bahrain and conferences in Armenia and Albania.
His number one client doesn't pay him. So he's got to get paid by somebody. I mean, are you suggesting that Rudy Giuliani's primary purpose for representing the president is so that he can sell his influence overseas?
Absolutely. The quantum of influence peddling with President Trump has led to millions of dollars in receipts by Mr. Giuliani and his firm.
Drew Griffin joins me right now. Hey, Drew, we know prosecutors have been investigating Giuliani's business dealings in Ukraine. Is he a target at this point?
Anderson, what sources are telling CNN is that Giuliani's actions are certainly a central focus of this now months-long inquiry into Ukraine. But because he is the president's lawyer and an election is coming up, we're told not to expect things to move on him that quickly, not just because there's an election, but also because these cases involving violations in foreign lobbying acts are very hard to prove and just they just could take longer, Anderson.
You also mentioned in your piece that Hunter Biden stepped away from the work in Romania. Do we know what he was doing exactly?
Officially, we do not know what he was doing there. We do know that he was called in for some kind of legal help from a source. Apparently, he didn't have the ability or the skills needed for the job, and so he immediately assessed the situation and brought in Louis Free. But we don't know what the exact work it was that Hunter Biden actually did.